Hello people, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Aviral and in this video we're going to discuss about how to make a 3D movie in LTM Designer. So for 3D movie, I divided this whole tutorial into two sections. In the first section, as you can see, we'll discuss how to define the bending of rigid flex PCB. So it is a part of 3D movie where we'll bend the PCB at certain angle. And the second section is create a 3D movie in LTM Designer using output job file. So just for a brief, here I will tell you guys how to define the bending from scratch and how to create a rigid PCB from scratch. So that is the thing. And in the 3D movie section, I will discuss about the 3D movie editor, what are the different tabs that we can use to create 3D movie. So before going further, you can see this is a kind of PCB that we're going to create, and you can see if I press one in my keyboard, so you can see in the board view there are a lot of stack ups that I have used, and a lot of PCB sections. So like it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, total 7 number of sections, right? And these are all the bendings. So if I demonstrate, press 3 to go to the 3D mode, and here you can see the fold state. So if I drag this bar, you can see our PCB is folding at certain angle, right? So this is completely manually defined, and there are a lot of instructions that we're going to follow to create this one. If you guys don't know which software I'm using, this is LTM Designer 20.1.14 version, and if you guys want to use this software for PCB designing, you can simply go to the link given in the description and download the trial version of LTM Designer. So in my YouTube channel there are a lot of videos from scratch. You can just go through with those videos, and if you guys didn't subscribe my channel, please subscribe it. So let's open the LTM Designer, and here we're going to create the PCB project first. So go to the file, new project, and rename it anything. So I'm just renaming it bending flex PCB, right? Create. That's it. Now the next step is we're going to add the schematic file. Although it is not needed, so we'll directly going to add the PCB file. And the next step is add a output job file. That's it. Now open the PCB file, and here what we're going to do, we'll just going to create a shape first using the top overlay. So just select the top overlay, and here you can see we have to select the line. So left click over this line. Now we're going to change the grid. So for changing the grid size, press G on your keyboard and select it 1 mm, left click. Now let's define the shape. So just draw any random shape. I'm just following the same I've drawn, the design I've shown you. Like this. We'll adjust the size because it's kind of random shape, so just make it about symmetric. Yeah, this is fine. So now we'll select the line and press tab. So you can see all the line is selected. Now what we'll do, we'll go to the design, board shape, and click over define from selected object. Right. So I've already noted down these all the steps here, and I'll upload this file on Google Drive and send the link on the description. So you guys can download this file from there. So I've written all the instruction, what instruction you should follow. The next step is we'll just align the center. So just change the grid to 1 mm first. Go to the edit, origin, set, and set it to the corner of this board, right? Yeah, that's it. Now what we'll do, we'll just define the layer stack up for flexible PCB and the rigid PCB. So as you can see from the document also, so just save all those files. I'm not just going into detail how to save those, so just go to the folder wherever you want to save and save these files. So after this we'll so the next step is split the board. So the for splitting the board, we have to press the one, go to the design and select the define split line. So open the LTM designer, press one, go to the design and define split line. So split line means it will basically just divide the boards or section the board. So we can make a particular section a flexible PCB and another section a rigid PCB. Okay, so again press G first, change the grid to 1 mm again, define the split line, make sure it is straight. Okay, so you can see like board is divided into two part now, so we'll again create more parts. And we create one here. Like this. Just kind of straight. Hold on. Yeah. And we'll again create more section. So as you can see, I've created 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, total 5 sections. The next step is layer stack up editing. So we'll go to the, again, press 2 on your keyboard. So go back to 2D mode, go to the design, layer stack manager. Yeah, and here you can see, this is the default layer stack up. So what I'll do, I'll just select the, go to the feature and from there select the rigid flex PCB. Now I can add the multiple stack ups using this plus button, right? So I'm using this default stack up for rigid PCB. I'll just press again and this stack up stack one, this will be our flex PCB. Okay, and you have to click over here to make it flexible PCB. So left click there and just verify the other stack up is not flex and this one is flexed, right? We'll save it. Now go to the PCB, press one, double click here and define which stack up you are using for this section. So I'm using the board layer stack up for this section and making it a 3D locked. So this will be the reference of our whole bending. So whenever we bend our board, it will bend around this locked section. Okay, this one is flexible, so I'll make it flex and place a custom coverlay so we can just visualize this. Okay, and I'm just making it flex center. Okay, and this one will be also flex, so it will be flex side or flex bottom, you can say, and place custom overlay here also, overlays. So as you can see, it kind of auto assigned the bending here. You can see if I hold the left bar here, sorry, the left key of mouse here and press tab, we can just edit the property of bending. So I want around this, like we can go for any angle. So I'll just go for any random angle, like 100 degree. And the radius of, so there is a formula that we can use for estimating these things. Plus it also depends on your manufacturer, what are their capability of manufacturing a rigid PCB. So they basically mention that how much you can bend, okay. So the simple formula is this one, W is equal to E upon 60 into 2 pi R. So here you can see W is this one, the circumference, and R is the radius, and A is the angle of bending, okay. So using this formula, LTM automatically create the affected area, okay. So this, at least this much area we required for bending for these parameters, okay. So let's go for 3 mm as per my manufacturer, which is NextPCB. Yeah, so here we're going to place another bending. So before this, I just want to adjust this thing. Yeah, now it's fine. Now again, go to the design and select the define bending lines. I'm just going to place a bending line here also. And just edit the property. So for editing the property, just select the bending line and press tab. So you can go here again, I'll go for the same specs, 2 mm, and this thing also depends on the height of component that you're going to place on the rigid PCB. So from my experience, I would recommend minimum 5 mm clearance between the flexible PCB, the bended part of PCB and the component placed. So just careful for that. Here we go. Okay, we didn't assign this one, the flex PCB. So we have to just define the bending line again. So for deleting this, just again hold the bend line and press delete, and it will delete, right? So again, go to a design, define bending line. Make it straight. Again, hold the left button on the bending line and press tab to edit the properties. So again, go for 2 mm. Okay, here we go. So we have defined the bending line. Now the next section is how we can edit the bending. So as you can see, we have two bendings in our PCB. So the next step is go to the PCB tab, and if it is not here in your case, just go to the panel and select the PCB. Okay, now change it to layer stack region and all layer stack up. So as you can see here, we have selected all the layer stack up, and we have to just focus on the flexible part, right? So here you can see the angle of bending is 100, and the sequence of bending. So if it is 0, then it will start bending from the beginning, and if it is 1, then firstly this section will bend, then this section will bend, right? So I'll go like that only. So I'll make this section, so to select this one, just select the flex bottom and change sequence to 0, and angle will be 180 degree, okay. And select the flex center and double click on this one, change it to sequence 1, okay. So now that's it, we have prepared our bending PCB. Now press 3 on your keyboard. So go to the 3D mode, right, and start folding. So as you can see, folded our PCB as per the specification. So till here we have completed the first section. In the second section, we're going to create a 3D movie. So the step one of the first section is the introduction of 3D movie editor. So go back to LTM Designer, and you can see here I'm on the 3D editor window right now. And if it is not showing here, you can just open it from the PCB panel. So just click here and it will open. So now we're going to create a 3D movie. So for that, you have to just press new here, and you can just change the name of this one. So I'm just making it Flex PCB 3D movie. Okay. And here we go. So now the next block is Flex PCB 3D movie keyframes. So in keyframes, what are basically keyframe? If you guys have done video editing before, you can like in After Effects or other software. So there also we use keyframe for recording any movement. So here also, like if I rotate the PCB and I have to record that rotation, I have to just add a 3D keyframe for that duration, right? So let me show you. So firstly, just make it just zero rotation. So press go to the view and left click on zero rotation. So it will be like this. Now the next step is go to the new and left click on add. So and rename it zero position. Duration will be like this. You don't need to change it. It will start from here. Now the next step is we'll rotate it. So here I will show you how to define a keyframe for rotation. So let's rotate it not like this one, rotate it like this. So what I did, I just hold the shift key and the right click of mouse, and holding those, and if you drag the mouse, you can simply able to rotate the PCB. So I just rotate it like this, and again left click here and add another keyframe. So it will add a 3 second keyframe here. So if we, so there is another section which is the frame rate and all. I'll come back this thing later. So here you can see a bar. So if I drag this bar, you can see our rotation is kind of recorded, and this all rotation will happen in this duration, 3 second. Okay, like this. Right. If you wanna add something else, suppose so another step is I will show you how to add a keyframe for zoom in or zoom out. So what you can do, again press shift and control, hold it again, press the right key on your mouse and just drag the mouse. So you can simply zoom in and zoom out the PCB. So I'll just zoom in first and add another keyframe for 3 seconds. So again we'll see what happened. You can see it's just rotated, then zoomed, right? Now I'll go for the zoom out. So again, what you guys need to press control shift and right click on your mouse and drag the mouse, right? So it is like before. Again add a keyframe for 3 seconds, right? So this one is for rotation, this one is for zooming, and this one is for zoom out, right? Now we're going to add the this thing, the folding of or you can say the bending of PCB. So again, what we'll do, we'll just fold it like this. Right? And again add a keyframe. Okay, and just rename it folding. So let's see what will happen. firstly zero position, then rotation, then zoom in, then zoom out, and then folding, right? So this is how we can add and simply just select any keyframe, and you can delete also if it is wrong. And you can also edit, you can just select the keyframe and edit at the that position, right? So this is how it works. Now the next step is go to the project. So firstly save the project, go to the output job file, and here I guess in the documentation output, right click here and select a PCB 3D video and PCB 1 PCB doc, right? Go to the video, select this enable tab, just configure this one if it is not selected. Yeah, so here everything is fine. Now generate the content. So now Alchem will create a kind, not a highly resolution video, but a small introduction video of your PCB, right? So as you can see, all the keyframes that we have created, it's kind of demonstrated in a simple small video. You can share it with your clients, and I mean, you can use it for any purpose, right? So this is the complete tutorial. And if you guys have any doubt, you can just put your questions on the comment section. I will reply those ASAP. And thank you.